Well, hey everybody, this is my buddy Chase. We're riding around Deals Gap Dragon area in his 2015 WRX. So Chase, why don't you tell us a little about your car?
I love my WRX. It has got 268 horsepower. 0 to 60 is in what Subaru says 5.2 seconds. Car and driver got it down to 4.8. I think it tops out at 147.
What is your favorite thing about this car?
Probably the all-wheel drive. Especially in the snow. It was amazing this year. Didn't get stuck anywhere except for a few impossible situations I put myself in.
What's your least favorite thing about this car?
It's a Subaru, which means a little unrefinement. There's some rattles here. Honestly, the paint's already got a few chips in some spots. I've only had it since July. And that's a Subaru, though. That's kind of part of owning one, is you're going to have a few little rattles and a few things that aren't totally lined up perfectly. Mm-hmm. And it kind of bothers me because I went from the GTI to this car. The GTI, I mean, was luxury car on the inside.
That's really interesting that you mentioned the GTI, because I have a GTI, but you've gone through a lot of cars, and I think you have a really interesting philosophy on how you go about getting cars and using cars. So why don't you share a little bit about that?
I like to have a car that's practical. I like to have one that's fun, and I put a lot of miles on a car. So usually at about 100,000, 120,000, it's gone, I replace it, and I get something different. I cannot have the same thing twice. I have no idea why, but I will never buy anything twice. I don't care if it's a toothbrush. I don't buy anything twice.
Like the same brand. You cannot buy the same brand toothbrush.
It's got to be different, got to be better, or unique in some way. That's the way I've been all my life.
And I'm going to test you here on that then. See if you've ever bought something twice. Okay, can you go to a fast food restaurant, the same one, twice in a week?
Fast foods, try to avoid it as much as I can.
See, look at that. Healthy,
yeah.
Spontaneous, doesn't like to be predictable.
Well, if I'm unpredictable, and everybody knows I'm unpredictable, aren't I predictable then?
Damn it. I don't think this is really anybody's idea of economy car.
But you have the people that are like, well, it's not a Mustang or Challenger or Charger. And I mean, it's 0 to 60 is faster than 90% of your cars. You get that a lot. It went from being a really aggressive model to it looks a lot more mature now. Everybody's like, well, it looks like a Camry with a hood scoop. Well, at least my hood scoop's functioning.
Yeah, so he's got a digital boost gauge here.
It tells how much pressure I put down on the pedal as well.
So you're a big guy. How much do you lift?
Well, in my prime, I bench 495.
You got pretty big back seats back there, right?
Yeah, back in there. Big back seats.
Where can you fit back there? In your rearview mirror?
I'm all weightlifting gear.
Oh, yeah. Very cool. Yeah, 400 is pretty good. I mean, you know, well, it's not 405.
No, I said 495.
Well, it's not 500. I'm not speaking from experience, but I'm speaking from, you know, I mean, the streets, mean streets of Alpharetta.
Oh, yeah.
Gated community swag. You learn how to cut first and cut deep. Do you get
the wave?
Yeah, you get the wave.
Oh, yeah. Every Subaru you pass, you get the wave. I just got it then. Mm-hmm. I didn't wave back, though. I feel bad now. I need to chase that dude down.
All right, here's your chance. There you go.
Got the wave.
What kind of modifications do you want to do to this car?
I would like to do intake, exhaust, but to do both, I have to get a tuner or run too lean. I would like to go full out on this car. I'd like to put a new set of rods, pistons in it, and then boost it harder.
What's the magical number in your head you're trying to go for horsepower torque-wise?
Well, right now, a lot of people are getting quite a bit out of it on just those products. The best I've seen is 396 to the tires.
Well, Chase, it's been awesome. Thank you very much for taking me for a ride.
No problem.
Thanks for tuning into the T-Dub Diaries. Catch you on the flip side. That's such a bad outro. What the heck?